From mountains, valleys, to sandy plains, to Florida, the gender war rages with a relentless internet momentum. Fear not, nameless men and women, I am your savior. Too many memes have been launched. Too many accounts have been frozen. It must end.
First monogamy.
Let's start with the ladies. You guys have to remember that you are the gatekeepers, and with great power comes great responsibility. Men are launched into the world with a bag full of sperm, bursting the seams, and have no idea how to release it. We can't even hold it in Parliament. We have to endure breakups, endless rejection, confusion, embarrassment, and envy. And an increase in the online spotlight of female exploitation through gives many men the impression that feminists are a group of
gold-digging whores.
On top of all of this, we're collectively derided for the small potential of men who get the game while languishing in a pool of our own Greek yogurt. It's not hard to see how many guys aspire to be the villain, to take back what they felt only a small number of men were able to grasp. If I'm trash, and women only see me for status and financial gain, then I'll join Hustlers University and defend the tapedom. And what about personal responsibility? Your bodies are the most important things you'll ever own. Is it a man's fault that he wants to experience them, or should there be some personal responsibility for surrendering it to virtual strangers? Think of it like this. You know that salesman in every tourist center that claims they have the best price? If you believe them without checking their claims and get screwed, is it the fault of Mr. Cheap, the local Turkish salesman? Or is some reflection needed to avoid that situation in the future? And so, you could view us with a little empathy. Stop disregarding everyone who dissents as an incel. Now onto the lads. Not gonna lie, doesn't look good. Let's admit it, the ladies have a point. The rapes, murders, domestic violence, not to mention routine manipulation, and worst of all, sneako. It's not a good look. Plus, we demand too much. All this talk of modern versus traditional women and gender roles belies a simple reality. Most men are not in the position to provide patriarchy, even if they wanted to. Subjugation requires financial independence.
If you're irritated at women, there's something wrong with you, because they're right. You're wrong.
And come on, lads. The Manosphere is a bit harsh. What the Tates and his offspring represent more than anything else is the first exposure of women to how lads talk. If you think telling women she's a 304 superficial bitch is a good persuasion tactic, congratulations, you've passed Hustlers University, and now you have a certification to prove you're an incel. Let's be honest, most ladies are clueless about the games we try to play. The fact that her male friend wants the nut in her skull, the fact that we are so entrapped by beauty it's very hard to tell if we like you before, the fact that promiscuity is inherently dangerous because predators often can't be detected on first impression and will always be present. So lads, have some empathy, listen to her, understand what she's saying, but on the flip side, don't call him a loser, because being bad with women doesn't mean you're bad at violence. Hi Andrew, I'm joking, don't. Jokes. So now each side has been sufficiently roasted, what we need to do is get together in a semicircle and discuss, with empathy, how to resolve the current crisis. Feminists have well documented the struggle of dealing with gender-based violence and patriarchal values, but many since Tate have begun to realize there is a crisis of masculinity at play.
We tell men that their worth is basically what their earning power is. Sure. Are you able to like get a job, support the family, do the thing? And then we've stripped them of the ability to do that. And so you have so many young men who, you know, aren't able to have that sort of stable middle class life that they expected to be able to inherit, that they saw, you know, maybe their grandparents living that type of, you know, having the stable job and being able to support and provide for a family. You see now things like being able to own a home, being able to get married, getting pushed increasingly out of reach and becoming like a luxury good. And so, yeah, they're looking for like who to blame.
Men are struggling to find meaning in a world where the pressures of traditional masculinity weigh without a reasonable means to achieve them. Put yourself in the shoes of an average teenage boy. You've received a surge of intense hormonal feelings, but feel like it's virtually impossible to exercise them as you don't know how to talk to women and are increasingly isolated from the relevant social media bubbles. At the same time, you see all these guys on social media achieving status, Bugattis, and attention from beautiful women. And so, begin to get more and more absorbed in their worldview. And what happens when you grow up? You're in the shitters. No one cares about you. The alienation only intensifies as you find yourself at the chopping block of a struggling economy with no hope, while the rich... We need to find a way to re-establish masculinity to the modern age. And if you want to know what that could be, like and subscribe. But don't listen to me, because this is the internet, so I have no solutions. And remember, support the strikes.